Hello and welcome my friend, and next I am planning to show you step by step that how to replace this Toyota Corolla's VVT-i engine, and I will show you all steps and those tools and very detailed level that how easy this Toyota Corolla's engine replace is. And this is really engine what we can find in USA. This is like this 1.8 liter gasoline engine, and then my friend, let's go to take next part away. Okay, and then first thing when we start this our job is that we have to remove this car battery. And here is this battery, and for that job we need now 10 millimeter socket and wrench, and I will go to take those tools next. And for that job we need really 10 millimeter wrench, what is in there, or 10 socket. And using these tools we can take this battery away. And let's go to do that. Okay, here is our battery. And this job starts so that I take this my 10 millimeter socket, and there is first bolt in here where I install this my socket, and I open that in this way. This is this opening direction, and soon we can rotate that, and then this part quite easily opens like in that way. And then there is second cable in hidden in here what we need to take also away. Okay, and the second bolt is behind this plastic cover, and when I move that we can see that its position is in here, and I open also this one. Okay, and there is this one bolt, and now this part is free and I can take that out. And this another part, there is really hook, and it is easy to open so that I rotate that, and then actually I move that in here, and then I move this battery holder away. Excellent. Okay, and then my next step is to open these battery cables, and we start that always in minus area, and there is my 10 millimeter wrench, and it fits in here, and let's go to look that bolt closer. Okay, and there we can see this our target area, and now I install this my wrench in here, and I rotate that bolt about 5 to 10 times. This is, and then this bolt opens, and then I move this cable and pull out, and now this cable is free. And then same thing in this plus area, and there is opening direction is in that way, and I can move this holder, and now bolt is free, and also movement and cable is now free. Okay, and then when cables are free, I can lift this battery away so that I take my hand in here or then in this size. And remember, this is quite heavy, weight about 20 pounds. Good. Okay, and then my next step is to take out this air filter console. And there is firstly, I have to unconnect this, this sensor area. There is airflow muff sensor, in here, and let's go to look at how I take this sensor away. Okay, and now we can see the sensor, and I need to press that central area. There is this clamp and this close and open button, and then when I press, I pull out this, and I a little bit move that, and same time I reverse and return this connector, and now this part is free. Okay, excellent. And then there is second connector, what I need to open also. And then there is second this sensor, what is very similar, and it is just in here, and also in that area I press that and pull out. There is also this idea that I press. And now I can move these connectors in other area. Okay, and then my next step is to remove this air hose, what is rubber, what is between this throttle body and then this air filter console. And there is two clamps in here, and now in my case I need screwdriver, and when I open these two bolts in here, then we can continue. And there is first clamp, and I rotate this clamp. This is clamp what I need to rotate. And I open that. And then when it is loosened, I can go in that another one. And let's go to look closer. Okay, and there is really this upper clamp. And I install my tool, and this is opening direction. And now this part is loosened. Excellent. Good. And then when both clamps are loosened, I can take my hand and I can move this part in here, and then that clamp also I pull out this in that way. Excellent. And now this part is free. Okay, and then remember to check that these areas, that there is no any dirties, because this is critical air hose. And then we can continue our job. Okay, and next part what I need to take out is this air filter console box, and there are clamps what I open in this way, and then I need to only lift this side out, and then also take this cable away in that way, and there is air filter, and then there are two cables what I need to unconnect. Okay, and this is first hose what goes to this throttle body, but now I need to take this plastic cover out. Okay, and now I need to take this plastic cover out, because we need to look those hoses what goes to throttle body. And now I open, there is two ball nuts, one in here and second in here, and I open firstly this nut in here. There is more nut in that area, and then second in this area. And these are easy to open. And these nuts are really, they are specific nuts. And let's go to look closer these nuts, because they are very interesting. Okay, and then we can look closer these nuts, and I have small pliers, and there is second nut, and they are specific nut for this plastic cover. Okay, and now when two bolts are free, this cover is easy to remove, and this cover is also important because there is in this back area, this is sound insulation material, and this cover makes this Toyota's engine more silent, and now this cover, plastic cover, is free. Okay, and now we can remove this hose, but remember that this hose places we must be all time to sure that we have right cables in right connectors, and that's we have to mark these cables. And let's go to mark this cable in cable number 1. And now I have in tape in here, and then I have mark in here number 1, and this cable position is in that one, and then we have to go to look that in where this cable starts and where it ends. And let's go to look closer. Okay, and now when we look that hose number 1, it starts from this air filter consoles. There is this one air sensor, and this sensor goes to this emission control box. And now when I like to take that out, I can carefully rotate that, or then I can use pliers and open. And look, this cable goes in that way. And this is throttle body, and it goes in that upper one area. There is this hose. It goes directly in that position, and next I remove this hose. Okay, and now we can see this area closer. This is throttle body, and there is this my cable number 1. And now when I little bit open this clamp and I use my fingers, I can open that, but now I need my pliers. Okay, and there is my pliers, and I compress this clamp in there, and then I move this my hose carefully in that way, and now this hose opens. Excellent. Okay, now we can see that this my hose is free, and also this my clamp, and now I need my pliers. Okay, and if I have long pliers, I can take firstly this my metallic clamp away, and then there is this hose, and this hose connector, it goes in that hose, this part, and now it's free, it goes in that pipe in here, what I am now touching. And now this my hose is also free. Okay, now this my hose is free, and it is really number 1. And there was that kind of clamp what takes contact to throttle body in this way. And then this another part, there was another clamp in here. And now we have take out this number 1 hose. And then we can continue.